it starts a little bit like this. You pack a 50 pound rucksack, you stick your walking boots on, you walk up a hill, you get your iPad out and you paint. More often than not, like in this particular case, involves a 5-hour journey to somewhere that's going to inspire you to paint, because I can't really paint in the studio anymore. It's just not worth it. An hour on the mountain is worth a year in a studio. Well, it's coming up to dusk and I've got to find somewhere to sleep. Typically, it involves the forest. I've got to find somewhere where there's 12 paces between two reasonably straight trees so I can sling up a hammock and then wait for the sunrise. Today, it's been a bit dank, low cloud base, a bit claggy. Hopefully tomorrow morning we'll have some beautiful sunrise. Well, good morning. It is just past 6:30 and you might be thinking, why am I not painting? Well, frankly, we've got an overcast sky and the sun is just barely, as you can see, managing to break through. There is no interesting light. I can't paint if there's no interesting light. I find no interest in painting if the light doesn't inspire me. So I'm sat here freezing my bits off, waiting for the sun to improve. Start putting your bivy away.
Yep.
Say good morning to your friends.
Good morning.
Get them to put their bivy away.
Yep.
And start walking to the other side of the lake. Now, here's something, one of those things for the bucket list, one of the things you must do before you die. You must go to the Lake District. You will get there by many means. The M6 is a fantastic route. But if you do nothing else, climb on a train and go to Windermere. 1.5 kilometres from Windermere railway station, up a hill, which is the one I'm climbing now, as you can see, it's not too strenuous, there's a thing called Orrest Head. When we get there, I'm going to paint, not surprisingly. Now, one of the problems that I have painting outside, like you will have, is how cold it gets. It gets perishingly cold. It is singularly the biggest challenge that you have painting outside, especially when the sun goes down as it just has and the temperature starts to drop. The way I paint, slightly unusually, so I'm given to understand, is I put colour down as you would do if you were painting with a palette knife. Now, at the current time, you're thinking, what the devil is this? Where is he going with this? Well, let me show you. I just put some white in first. You see, it does get paler as you get lighter, as you get further towards the stratosphere. Some light in here, or light blue anyway. And then I want to get some of that yellow in there as well. And some orange. Definitely some orange. Look at that sky, it's getting more orange by the second. And then all I do, I get a palette knife and mix it in. Now, one of the joys of having a computer on a stand like this is you can just look at your subject a lot more than you would have been able to if you didn't have a stand. just in the process of putting in some of the light going down to Windermere Village. In the distance you can see the greys on top of the old man of Coniston. Now, this is as far as I'm going to take this evening, because I'm quite happy with that. What I'm just going to do now is get my palette knife, just blend in some of the colours. As you can see, the shadows of the early evening sort of reach out from the land into the painting.